Bangladesh. A country characterized by lush greenery, rivers, and coasts is one of the world's most densely populated countries. Here, harmony with nature is a way of life. However, climate change threatens agriculture in Bangladesh. Many crops can't survive saltwater intrusion, extreme heat, and severe droughts. The vulnerable communities of Bangladesh need to adopt new agricultural practices suitable for the changing circumstances and build food security before it's too late. Research can help to turn the tide. Knowledge needs to be gathered on how to adapt agricultural practices in keeping with the changing climate. In a step towards this goal, Patuakhali Science and Technology University collaborates with Wageningen University and Research, CIMMYT, Acacia Water, and the Salt Doctors.
For me, this project is a start of a collaboration with this university. I think we have many things in common.
This project is called RECSA, Climate Smart Agriculture for a Resilient Coastal Bangladesh.
The main goal of the RECSA project is to build a resilient agriculture in coastal Bangladesh so that the Bangladesh can be self-sufficient in food security in the long run.
What is Climate Smart Agriculture? Climate Smart Agriculture is an approach that helps to guide actions to transform agriculture systems towards green and climate resilient practices.
Climate Smart Agriculture focuses on reducing greenhouse gas emissions, agricultural adaptation, and improving food security.
Project RECSA aims to increase knowledge and capacity on climate smart agriculture to train local farmers, students, and scientists, and to initiate new research projects. There are various studies to identify alternative crops that are resistant to climate change.
If you look at this soil, this is really dry, and you can see that in that particular field, the crop is not that well, or even it's harder for the plant to grow here. But in the same soil, if you look at here, this plant is really growing good. So therefore, it is a drought-resistant crop and can be grown in the drought-prone area.
The identification of stress-resistant crops can also enable farmers to produce food all year round.
To high salinity, in the dry season, actually farmers remain their land as fallow.
With salt-tolerant crops, farmers could also produce food in the dry season and thereby improve food security.
In the treatment, I use 4 salinity level to identify which rice genotypes is more tolerant or show their tolerance to which level of salinity. I need to find some genotypes which can show their better growth or better yield under high salinity level.
Plant diseases are affecting crop production and they intensify due to climate change. With location-specific weather information, farmers can prepare for rice diseases and limit yield loss.
If you use climate information service and weather forecast and keep in mind what will be the weather today or after the next 7 days, then you can easily schedule your pesticide and fertilizer application. So this is a great advantage for them.
Project RECSA supports various farmer field schools, one of them specifically aiming at training women. All these studies will be anchored at the Patuakhali Science and Technology University, where a new department on climate smart agriculture has been set up to develop knowledge for community-led agriculture initiatives.
It's very much lucky to have such a building at PSTU campus. students are very much happy to be trained here face to face by some resource persons.
Together with farmers, researchers and coastal communities, we build long-term resilience to better withstand the effects of climate change in Bangladesh, thereby improving people's lives.